Welcome to the Scholars Learning Classes. In this video, we will be studying about some special items that are treated in the cash flows and how these items are treated. Now, the first one is your interest and dividend. Right? Now, there can be two aspects to this. Either you have received the interest and dividends, or you have paid the interest and dividends. Now, if you have received the interest and dividends, which means you might have invested the amount somewhere and you are receiving the interest or the dividends on the investment. So, it will be into the investing activities. But if we say that the interest or dividend have been paid, you will be paying the interest, you will be paying the dividend only when you have taken loans or you have financed the funds from outside into your organization. So it will be treated into the financing activities of cash flows. The second one is taxes on income. Now, taxes on income, if it is given, then in that case it is deducted from the cash flows of operating activities because it is directly related to the operation. But if it is given in the adjustment, so in that case we need to make the double entry. So once we'll add back into the profit and then we'll subtract it from the operating activity. That will tell you when we'll do the numerical on it. Third is extra ordinary items. Now, your extraordinary items means your cash flows relating to extraordinary items such as your bad debt received or any claims received from insurance, winning of a lottery or investing should be disclosed separately as arising from operating, investing or financing. For example, that if you have received the amount from the insurance company on the loss of your inventory by fire or earthquake, etc. So in that case it will be treated into the operating activities. So it depends upon the type of extraordinary item that from where it is originating. Then significant non-cash transactions. Now in that case, there are some investing and financing activities which do not require the use of cash or cash equivalent. So in that case, it should be excluded from the cash flow statements. For example, the conversion of debentures into shares, this you will not take into consideration. For example, that you have issued the acquisition of asset by issue of debenture or shares, you have taken the assets and what you have done, instead of paying them cash, you have issued the shares of your organization. So in that case also there is no outflow or inflow of cash. So in that case also there will be no transaction that you will be taken into the cash flow statement. So this was some of the special treatment of the cash flow statement. I hope you like our video. Please download our Scholars Learning app and enjoy the learning experience with us.